We are only two teachers. Either me or Seema ma'am will be teaching in your class 11. So please write down when we are saying this is important. This is questions are asked like this. Most of the time we are telling you the hint. This portion can be asked in this particular manner. Okay. If all of you are comfortable with me block, only two ways are there. Either you have studied or you have not studied. If you have not studied, then please start studying. Whenever you have doubt, please do ask. So I'm starting with the next chapter. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Next chapter that we are doing is state of matter. Under state of matter, you have two concepts, that is gaseous state and liquid state. For one, this particular liquid state is related. So we'll be mainly talking about gaseous state. When we talk about state of matter, what do you mean by state of matter? This we have already studied in class 9. This is the continuing current. What
will be the state of matter? Can
you repeat your question? What is the state of matter?
Ma'am, the different forms of matter can acquire.
Ma'am, physical form.
Physical forms. It can be solid, it can be liquid, it can be gaseous. That's the state of a matter. No, state of matter depend upon which two things.
Pressure and volume.
Bolo.
Pressure and volume.
Intermolecular forces, sir.
Good one. Intermolecular forces. Second. This is the diagram
to show for the temperature.
Yes.
Ma'am, the volume.
Volume, I can say that the intermolecular space.
Yes, ma'am.
If I'm giving you this particular diagram representation, can I use this representation for a solid state?
No, ma'am.
No. Can I use this for the liquid state? No, because the molecules are far away. Because in liquid state, molecule has to be not that much far. Is it okay? Molecules are far away, but not that much as compared to gaseous state. Okay. Well, let's talk about these two concept separately one by one. Now, intermolecular forces. Intermolecular forces say, what do you mean by intermolecular forces? Kadavali.
On the forces which
make the force of attraction between molecules.
Lekhovi, very definition. Forces of attraction between two molecules. Forces of attraction between any two molecules known as intermolecular forces. Ab sochke bata. Next, we have types of intermolecular forces. Types of intermolecular forces. Suppose I am getting helium. Helium is an example of a polar molecule or non-polar?
Non-polar
helium, it contains protons at the center, two electrons, and these two electrons are uniformly distributed. Is the reason? Because the electrons are placed in s orbital, and s orbital is spherical, uniformly distributed. Similarly, right. Attraction, whenever we talk about, forms of the electrostatic attraction. It's a force which is between
nucleus and electron.
Right. Electron or a proton, or I can say negatively charged machine and a positively charged machine. Now here what happens? Negative charge and positive charge. So if we present only, then I can talk about intermolecular forces of attraction. Right? For a given as a force, when electrons are moving, right? For a given moment only, it may be possible that these two electrons may shift to a particular site. It may be possible during the movement of this electron density, of this electron. Now the electrons have moved, both the electrons have moved to a particular site. True. Right? Now what happened here? There's a shift in electron density in this side, developing negative charge over here, delta negative charge over here, and delta positive charge over here because of the absence of electron density. ठीक है? इतना clear है बेटा? For a moment, just for a moment.
Yes, ma'am.
These two electron may come towards a particular side. Developing or the electron density increases on that particular side, and on the other side there's a decrease in electron density. Now there's a decrease in electron density means partial positive charge is created. Now this helium atom, which has uniformly distributed electron, will start attracting because of this partial positive charge. It starts electron density toward its side. This side also will develop partial negative charge, and this side will have lesser electron density, so it will have partial positive charge. So for a given moment, because of the movement of electrons, the electron density shifted in such a manner that it will develop a partial negative charge and a partial positive charge. And here it get this species inducing, they get charge separation in another atom. This type of forces, now pehle kya tha, uniformly distributed tha, non-polar tha, there is no forces of attraction. But here during their movement, just for a fraction of second, this results into separation of charges, and which results into electrostatic force between these two atoms. Now these two atoms start attracting each other. And if I am taking a box full of helium atoms, there what will happen? In a way, from one atom to another, to the another one, this intermolecular forces of attraction start operating.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And this is known as example of van der Waals forces. This is a type of van der Waals forces. Van der Waals forces means very weak forces. For example, when I talk about ionic bonds, I say electron move from one atom to another, right? Stronger. Magnitude of electron transfer is plus one and minus one. When I'm talking about sharing of electrons, again, powerful. And the force of attraction will be much higher. But here, you can see I'm talking about delta positive charge or delta negative charge. This positive, delta positive, delta means very small. Okay. Though these two atoms are attracting each other, but the magnitude of force of attraction is very less. And these smaller forces of attraction, we call it as a van der Waals forces, though small. But because this is present in between all the molecules, earlier it was not there, it will make a significant difference in the properties of these atoms. Is it okay? Please write it down. First example under van der Waals forces is your London forces. Please write the London forces. Okay. Atoms and non-polar. Please write atoms and non-polar molecules which are electrically symmetrical. Which are electrically symmetrical. Please write, beta. Atoms and non-polar molecules which are electrically symmetrical and have no dipole moment. And have no dipole moment. Clearly, no dipole moment underlined below. No dipole moment. It may be possible momentarily. It may be possible momentarily this charge density over a particular atom shifts to a particular side.
Could you repeat once again?
It may be possible for a small fraction of time, for a small moment, for a given moment, this electron density shift to a particular side. Results in instantaneous dipole. Results in instantaneous dipole. Now, because of this instantaneous dipole, it will induce dipole moment. But what is dipole? How will you define dipole? Dipole moment is product of
charge into distance.
Product of charge separation into distance. अब यहाँ पे क्या आ गया? Charge separation आ गया. There is a distance between these two charges. So here it will. This momentarily produced dipole moment induces, is right, induces dipole into another atom B. Induces dipole into another atom B. This induces dipole in another atom B. This induces dipole in another atom B. Next, the temporary dipole. These dipoles are not permanent. It's temporary. The temporary dipole of A and B is right. The temporary dipole of A and B. The temporary dipole of A and B attract each other. Attracts each other. And similarly between all other molecules. So this is known as London forces or dispersion forces. Dispersion forces.
Ma'am, can you repeat from the starting ones?
Kiska beta?
Ma'am, London forces definition.
Child, due to the sudden shift in electron density of a particular atom, non-polar atom toward one side, it will develop a negative charge on one side or partial positive charge on the other. It means it has introduced a dipole. It has experienced, it has created an instant dipole moment. And this dipole moment of this atom is able to induce dipole in another atom. Is able to induce dipole in another atom, and in a way they start attracting each other. So this is one example of van der Waals forces. One example of van der Waals forces. Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Next, look at the second time. Dipole induced that. For example, if I take a molecule like HCl, HCl means chlorine is more electronegative, there's a charge separation, so it will have a permanent dipole. This permanent dipole moment, when placed in a molecule like helium, right? Now what will happen here? This electron density present over here will repel the electron density of the helium atom present over here. In a way, it will shift this electron density toward this side, opposite side, introducing delta negative and delta positive charge induced. Pehle nahi tha. Because of this, you have a charge separation. Samajh mein aa raha. Induced. Theek hai? So one of the molecule, if I'm mixing two substances, one of them is having permanent dipole, another one is not having dipole. It's a nonpolar, but still, in presence of this dipole substance which is having dipole moment, it induces dipole. And this induced in dipole results into charge separation, and this molecule also starts experiencing force of attraction between molecules. Please write with example. In this, we'll be talking about mixture of two substances, one which is having mixture of two substances, one which is having permanent dipole and another one which is not having any dipole moment, which is nonpolar in nature. Because of the presence of a permanent dipole, it induces this permanent dipole, induces dipole in another molecule. Then, because of this induced dipole, it also results in charge separation. And because of this charge separation, we talk about force of attraction. आप सबको याद है कि आप क्लास 8 में पढ़ते थे लाइटनिंग वाला चार्ज सेपरेट होते हैं पॉजिटिव चार्जेस जनरेटेड तो अर्थ में नेगेटिव चार्जेस जनरेटेड दैट इज व्हाई द लाइट्स दे आर अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स द अर्थ पढ़ते थे ना ये वही कॉन्सेप्ट है इंड्यूस का ठीक है थर्ड लिखो बेटा
मैम
हाँ जी
मैम कैन यू रिपीट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ डाइपोल्स इंड्यूस्ड डाइपोल
Write it down in your own words. Here, if you are having mixture of two substances, one of them is having permanent dipole, another is nonpolar in nature. This molecule with a permanent dipole induces dipole in a nonpolar molecule. Induces dipole in nonpolar molecule. And due to this induced dipole, these two start attracting each other. And similarly, if I'm having millions of such molecules, they start experiencing force of attraction towards each other. And this type of forces of attraction is known as dipole-induced dipole. Dipole-induced dipole.
Ma'am, is it a permanent force of attraction or temporary?
Dipole moment of this particular molecule is permanent. If I'm mixing two things, if I'm adding two things together, I do mix the two in container. Here, this particular molecule is not experiencing any force of attraction. Iske molecules ke beech mein bhi koi force of attraction nahi. But when I'm adding this particular substance, then it starts experiencing force of attraction because this has induced dipole in this. And because of this, the two start operating, attracting each other. Electrostatic forces. When you drop two balloons and stick it to the wall, or you drop your comb or your dry hair and then bring it near the small papers, it gets attracted, right? Same way, electrostatic forces of attraction start operating between. Give it up. Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Next write with that. Dipole dipole. It's not engaged. Next write dipole dipole. Before writing dipole dipole, one thing, ek cheez isme likho beta. When I'm talking about London forces, the London forces, pehle wale ko bata dijiye. Forces depend upon 1/RL/6. The force of attraction between two molecules in London forces is directly proportional to 1/RL/6. Then,
R stands for what?
Radius. Radius. Or you can also say it's an angle. R is the distance between the two molecules. dipole, induced dipole may be same. For both London forces and the dipole induced dipole. This force is directly proportional to 1 by r raised to power 6. तो जितना डिस्टेंस मॉलिक्यूल दूर होंगे उतना फोर्सेस क्या होंगे कम
लेस.
नेक्स्ट लिखो बेटा. नेक्स्ट लिखो डायपोल डायपोल. दिस फोर्सेस ऑफ अट्रैक्शन लिखो बेटा. दिस फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन इज ऑब्जर्व बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ परमानेंट डायपोल. बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ परमानेंट डायपोल सपोज आई एम हैविंग दिस हियर. I'm having another molecule of HCl. Now there's a charge separation. This will have delta negative and this will have delta positive charge. Similarly, this will have delta negative and delta positive charge. So even if I'm having billions of such molecules, there is a force of attraction between all these molecules. Okay? Likho beta. Dipole. Dipole forces. This is permanent forces. This is permanent forces which operates between molecules, which operates between molecules having permanent dipole moment. Now, if by this state of the molecule is solid, then the force of attraction is 1 by r raised to power 3. And if my molecules are rotating, again this force of attraction is 1 upon r raised to power 6. सॉलिड है तब 1 बाय आर एस
टू पावर रिपीट
क्या चल बेटा. रोटेटिंग इज इन बोथ द गैसियस स्टेट एज वेल एज इन लिक्विड स्टेट. ठीक है. रोटेटिंग मीन्स पार्टिकल्स आर मूविंग. मूविंग मीन्स फ्लो. ठीक है. फ्लूइड. सो फ्लूइड मीन्स बोथ गैसियस एज वेल एज लिक्विड. So there it is, forces 1 by r raised to power 6. Next,
Ma'am, this induced dipole and London forces and dipole all come under van der Waals forces, or these are
all of the different types of van der Waals forces.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Ab hota hai kya beta, few molecules jo when we say na, every substance has a different boiling point. Why they have a different boiling point? It depends upon the forces of attraction between them. When I say boiling, it means what I am doing. I have to remove this particular molecule from the force of attraction of other molecules. Right? Tabhi to I am able to convert a liquid into gaseous state or I am able to convert solid into liquid state. Boiling point or melting point. Right? Ab is case mein mujhe alag karna. So, us molecule mein कौन सी फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन है. जितनी ज्यादा फोर्स ऑफ अट्रैक्शन होगी राइट विदिन अ मॉलिक्यूल उतना ज्यादा मुझे एनर्जी सप्लाई करना पड़ेगी एंड मोर विल बी द बॉइलिंग और मेल्टिंग पॉइंट. इज इट ओके. इफ अ मॉलिक्यूल पोजेस ओनली पोलर, इफ अ मॉलिक्यूल इज पोलर ओनली, देन इट विल हैव ओनली व्हिच फोर्स टाइप ऑफ फोर्सेस. व्हिच टाइप ऑफ फोर्स? Polar molecule will experience which type of force?
Dipole force.
Polar.
Electrostatic force.
Correct. It will experience dipole force. Dipole force means more energy. They are attracted towards each other with greater force of attraction. So you require more energy in order to remove them. So the molecule which possesses dipole moment will have higher boiling point as compared to the molecule which is non-polar. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, clear? Next, right, fourth type is hydrogen bonding. fourth type is hydrogen bonding. The magnitude of hydrogen bonding is much stronger as compared to these three types of hydrogen forces. And hydrogen bonding is between hydrogen atom and oxygen, nitrogen or fluorine. Atom of same molecule or other molecule. This we have covered in detail in chapter 4, hydrogen bonding.
Yes, ma'am.
Intermolecular and intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So please write it down. Fourth type is hydrogen bonding, which is a force of attraction between hydrogen atom and nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine of the same molecule or different molecule. So here we'll be talking about intermolecular and intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Now, when I'm talking about these four types of van der Waals forces, whether it is London forces, dipole-dipole, dipole-induced dipole or hydrogen, what is the purpose of these type of forces? To bring molecule closer or to make them away from each other. Right, so intermolecular forces, where I'm talking about van der Waals forces, right? And the purpose is to bring molecules close. Right, to bring molecules close. One thing when I'm talking about intermolecular space, which thing is said about the intermolecular space? Will the space between two molecules will be closed or it will be away? Can be controlled by thermal, that is heat energy. This intermolecular space between two molecules, can it be controlled by heat energy? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
And when I'm saying heat energy, ultimately what is happening when I'm providing heat to the system?
Molecules are moving far away.
Correct. Molecule will absorb heat and convert this heat energy into their kinetic energy and they start moving. And this movement of electron or any molecules, and this movement of molecules will be in all the directions, the random directions. During this process, they may collide with each other or they may just go as it is, right? So here I'm having two factors. One is heat energy, another one is your van der Waals forces. This makes the molecules separate, move away from each other. This brings the molecule closer. Here, bring the molecules move away from each other. So, if I balance these two forces, right, properly, then I am able to convert my one state of matter into another state?
Yes, ma'am.
And for example, if I am having solid ice, that is solid water, if I provide heat energy, what will happen? Slowly this ice will melt into liquid water. And if it keep on heating this liquid water, what will happen?
Gaseous state.
Or easy to reverse karo beta. When I supply, instead of providing heat, it will take away heat. If I put that water into the freezer, ki intermolecular kya ho raha space? Kam hota ja raha hai, what will happen to the force of atomic? Force of attraction increases. Right? So, likh lo beta. These two factors together decide the state of a matter. Intermolecular forces, where we will be talking about van der Waals forces, and intermolecular space, which is decided by heat energy. So these two factors together decide the state of a matter. Okay. Now we are talking about gaseous state, right? First thing, gaseous state. Now the properties were of what about the gaseous state? First, two properties which are not of the color. First, talk about those properties which we have to know that it is gaseous state. Which properties we have to know that it is gaseous state?
The molecules are far apart from each other.
चलो लिख दे जो first point. Molecules are far apart from each other.
Very less molecular forces, intermolecular forces.
Can you please repeat better?
Very less intermolecular forces.
Second point. Very less intermolecular forces. अब ना तो मैं इंटरमोलिकुलर स्पेस देख पा रही हूँ, neither I am able to see the intermolecular forces. मुझे क्या नजर आता है गैसीय स्टेट के बारे में?
मैम नो फिक्स्ड शेप और वॉल्यूम.
ट्रैवल डिस्टेंसेस.
कैन यू प्लीज रिपीट?
मैम ट्रैवल टू लार्ज डिस्टेंसेस. एंड
इट कवर्स, लिखो, द शेप एंड वॉल्यूम इज नॉट फिक्स्ड. The shape and the volume of gases are not fixed. ठीक है ना, कितने भी स्पेस में जा सकता है, travel at a distance. So space and volume is not fixed. Is the example बताओ, if you have got a question, इसे prove करो, तो कैसे prove करोगे?
Mom, perfumes.
Perfumes.
Mom, air in a room. Mom, air in a room.
Correct. ठीक है, और बताओ?
Mom, essence stick.
Gases are?
I'm incense stick.
Incense stick, burning of an incense stick, na? Again,
ha. Huh. Gases are compressible.
Likho ji, very good. Please let me know. Gases are compressible. Where do we use this property that gases are compressible?
LPG, CNG.
CNG.
Very good. LPG. LPG is a perfect example where we compress gases to fill into a cylinder. Next, or batao?
Ma'am, low density.
Likho ji, low density. Or batao?
Ma'am, random movement.
Can you please repeat your line better?
Ma'am, random movement of molecules.
Random movement of molecule will give rise to it doesn't have fixed volume. Or batao?
Exerts pressure equally.
It exert pressure. Likho ji. Gases exert pressure. And ji, in all direction? Yes or no? Gases exert pressure. In all direction. Example बताओ.
All direction.
हाँ जी बताओ बताओ फिर से बोलना.
Ma'am, gases exert the pressure equally in all directions.
इसके example बताओ जो statement को justify करे.
Tires.
Can you please repeat?
Tires.
Tires. Can you please elaborate? आप ठीक बोल रहे हो, उसको elaborate तो करो.
क्योंकि टायर इन्फ्लेट हो जाता है.
करेक्ट, टायर इन्फ्लेट हो गया, एयर इन इट, इट गेट इन्फ्लेट एंड देन
एटमॉस्फेयर
प्रेशर. और बताओ और दूसरा एग्जांपल.
मैम शो हाई रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन.
अच्छा अभी हाई रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन नेक्स्ट मिनट लिखते, पहले से एग्जांपल बताओ. एक दूसरे ने बोला करेक्टली, when we fill air into the tires, tires inflate hote hain. Dusra?
Ma'am, atmospheric pressure hai.
Atmospheric pressure hai. ठीक है, और उस atmospheric pressure का ही concept हम आगे बात करते हैं. आप सब ने ना अपने कार के windows में वो press करके लगा दो seat सब black सा.
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
एक thumb से उसमें क्या create करते हैं? Vacuum create करते हैं. What do you mean by vacuum? वो जो सर्कुलर डिस्क होती है जिसको प्रेस करते हो, वो अपने में जितना भी एयर होता है ना उसको रिलीज कर देते, वो एयर रिलीज कर देते हो डायरेक्टली किस पे? हमारे ग्लास पे स्टिक कर जाती है. अब यहाँ पे निकलती क्यों रही? बिकॉज द एयर विच इज प्रेजेंट ओवर हेयर दे एक्सर्ट प्रेशर और वो स्क्रीन इट गेट स्टिक टू दैट पर्टिकुलर विंडो विच शोज दैट एयर एक्सर्ट प्रेशर. ठीक है, which shows that air exerts pressure. देखो बेटा एयर प्रेशर, द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एयर प्रेशर, और व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट दिस, क्या कहते हैं इसको, जो प्रेस करते हो आप ग्लास विंडो पे, द स्क्रीन द क्रिएट वैक्यूम है ना, दैट ऑल शोज कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इट एयर एक्सर्ट प्रेशर इन ऑल डायरेक्शन. Means right, as rightly told by Talat, I think higher rate of diffusion. Higher rate of diffusion. Maji, who will explain this point? Higher rate of diffusion. Who will explain higher rate of diffusion? Intermixing. Higher rate of diffusion. Intermixing of particles. जब समोसा बना रहा होता है, जलेबी फ्राई कर रहा होता है, नूडल्स बना रहा होता है, या पिज्जा बना रहा होता है, इवन बाय टेकिंग दैट स्मेल यू आर एबल टू टेस्ट द फूड आल्सो, राइट? ये डिफ्यूजन इंटरमिक्सिंग ऑफ पार्टिकल्स, राइट? सो यहाँ पे हम बात करते हैं किस चीज की, रेट ऑफ डिफ्यूजन इज वेरी हाई व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट गैसियस सब्सटेंस. तभी आप देखना जितने भी वेंडर्स, दोज व्हिच आर सेलिंग cold stuff like ice cream, they have a very bright banners. But those who are cooking samosas and all, they don't have any bright banner. But still, because of that smell, you are getting attracted to that particular food. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, there are certain laws, we say, as a cooking food. नेक्स्ट लाइन लिखो बेटा.
गैसेस फॉलो,
देखो बेटा गैसेस फॉलोस सर्टेन सर्टेन रूल्स. गैसेस फॉलो सर्टेन रूल्स दैट कम अंडर गैस लॉस. क्योंकि बहुत सारे फीचर्स हैं गैसेस के दैट विल बी स्टडीड अंडर गैस लॉ. First thing that we are going to study is Boyle's law. Boyle's law. This law talks about the relationship between pressure and volume. This law talks about the relationship between pressure and volume. And when I'm talking about this, temperature is constant. Temperature is constant. आप सबने experience करा होगा पिचकारी से खेला है कभी?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. This is how it works. You have a piston attached, right? This is how we see which carry and if I apply pressure over here. You can fill it with water, colored water.
उसका वॉल्यूम चेंज
होगा, राइट? व्हेन आई अप्लाई प्रेशर व्हाट विल हैपन?
वॉल्यूम विल चेंज,
वॉल्यूम डिक्रीज. ये जो पिस्टन है इसका नाम मूविंग वर्क, पिस्टन का हम को नया लगेगा.
एंड बिकॉज़ इट इज मूविंग इन वर्क द वाटर विल कम आउट.
वाटर विल कम आउट,
यस मैम.
इसी का रिवर्स स्टीम सोचो. ओके,
I am instead of taking water in this, if I fill it with air,
right?
Or the amount of the passage closer. And if I exert pressure, this will move inward. Will it exert pressure inward? No, what will happen to this particular cell?
Now, the gaseous molecules are occupying lesser volume. Now the gaseous molecule, because gaseous molecule means there is a large intermolecular distance. So when I am applying pressure, what will happen to the volume?
The volume will decrease.
Volume will decrease. Correct. If I take a big container, if I am having piston, and if I am taking one mole of gaseous substance, okay, it's not yet.
Now, if I exert pressure downwards, what will happen? This system will move here. All molecules which are present over here now will move to this particular region. Right? And if I exert more pressure now, more pressure is going to happen. Now they are much more closer. So if I am talking about pressure, so is the volume directly proportional or inversely proportional?
Inversely.
A point may come when you compress more gaseous molecules. The molecules may come so close to each other that they start operating force of attraction, and this force of attraction results into change in state from gaseous state to liquid state. This is what we call as a liquefaction. We can liquefy gases, for example, oxygen that is filled in the cylinders. Air liquefy that. Similarly, nitrogen, which is filled in cylinders. Where do we use nitrogen gas?
Ma'am, from freezing.
For freezing things or?
Flushing that gas in chips.
The moment you open your packet, nitrogen gas is released. But most time in nitrogen transport, fill gas is going to be liquid. Okay, what we are doing, we are compressing this thing. And when I'm applying pressure means bring the molecules closer. High pressure and low temperature. Low temperature means it will control which thing? Kinetic energy. Two condition for dynamic or to liquefy. High pressure and low temperature. Same concept. A P is proportional to 1 by V. Or I can say, in order to remove this proportionality, sign K upon V. Or I can say PV is equal to K. Or I can say PV is equal to K. Please write it down. PV is equal to K. Liquid statement. I hope this is clear to everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm rubbing this when I'm saying PV equal to K. I can also say at any given pressure and volume, P1 equal to K and P2 is equal to K from these two. I can also say P1 is equal to P2 meter.
Yes, ma'am.
Please write it down. And write the statement. Boyle's law at constant temperature, please write, at constant temperature, the pressure of a fixed amount of a gas, varies inversely with its volume. Varies inversely with its volume. So, itna likh liya beta?
On the case of this, if I make this graph of pressure and volume, as it increases the pressure, what happens to the volume? Keep on increasing. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Or any other thing. Jitna kam temperature hoga, utna ye wala graph ki distance kam hoga. Okay? Or you can also say lesser the temperature, lesser will be the volume. It's related.
less as the temperature, lesser will be the volume. Is it clear? Now, which thing is constant when I'm studying this pressure and volume relationship?
From temperature.
Temperature. So I'm going to isotherm means constant. In chemistry, isotherm means that is constant. Isotherm. That is a graph between pressure and volume. Right? Please write it down. The graph between pressure and volume is known as isotherm. And if I make the graph between pressure and one by V, if I use a graph between pressure and one by V, again I'll be getting a straight line. Again, I will be getting a straight line.
It is a straight line or a curve? Straight line.
Done.
Yes, ma'am.
ma'am, हम लोगों का फिजिक्स क्लास स्टार्ट हो गया है मैम.
नेक्स्ट क्लास स्टार्ट हो गया. चलो. Then we will continue in the next class, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Bye, everyone. One of you please give me the screenshot.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome, Jay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome.